their judges are the best qualified to take the bench, not just the best qualified Liberal donor to take the bench. Depuis des mois, les libéraux sont posés des questions sur le rôle de leurs donateurs et partisans dans les nominations judiciaires. Les Canadiens méritent de savoir que leurs juges sont les plus qualifiés au CSJ, qu'ils ne sont pas uniquement les donateurs libéraux les plus qualifiés. The Canadian Bar Association, law professors, and even former aides to the Justice Minister have raised concerns about the veto that Liberal list has been rumored to have on judicial appointments. The very fact that they run their appointments through something called Liberal list shows that there is one list for friends of the Liberal Party and another list for regular Canadians. This is another example of the entitlement culture created by Justin Trudeau. Last week, senior government sources claimed that Liberal list would no longer be used, but that's only after almost 6 years of appointments being determined by donor history and partisan activity. Only a few weeks ago, the Justice Minister had to take down a tweet congratulating one of his longtime friends and donors on being appointed to the bench, after it was revealed that the donor hadn't completed the appointment process. Process didn't matter because he was on the right list. Il y a quelques semaines, le ministre de la Justice a dû réitérer un tweet dans lequel il félicitait l'un de ses principaux donateurs. Ce même donateur a été nommé juge. Le tweet fut réitéré après qu'on a appris que le donateur en question n'avait pas suivi le processus de nomination. Previously, when the Minister of Justice was first asked about officials at the Liberal Party vetting judges, he denied this fact and said it wasn't true. But now we know the truth. Canada's Conservatives have serious questions about the unethical and often corrupt nature of appointments under Mr. Trudeau, and he must answer for it. Canadians deserve to know how long Liberal list had been used to have a veto on judicial appointments. Les conservateurs se posent des sérieuses questions sur la nature non éthique et corrompue de ces nominations. Justin Trudeau doit rendre des comptes. Les Canadiens doivent savoir depuis combien de temps les libéraux ont disposé d'un droit de veto sur les nominations judiciaires. Canadians deserve to know how many appointments were subject to the approval of the Liberals' partisan supporter database. And they deserve to know if the Liberals only promised to stop using Liberal list after they had compiled a short list for the Supreme Court vacancy this summer. Canada cannot afford to have further scandals and more of the same corruption from Mr. Trudeau and the Liberals. Why did the Justice Minister mislead Canadians? What was he trying to cover up for the Prime Minister? More scandals, more corruption, more cover-ups. This is what Canadians can expect from Mr. Trudeau and the Liberals. There's really only one choice to end their corruption and secure accountability in Ottawa. Canada's Conservatives. Encore des scandales, encore de la corruption, encore du camouflage. C'est toujours la même histoire avec Justin Trudeau et les libéraux. Pour mettre fin à la corruption et assurer la responsabilité à Ottawa, il n'y a qu'un seul choix, le Parti conservateur. Merci beaucoup, and I'm happy to take